Now that the sun's disk has vanished over the horizon, an automatic illumination scheme flicks on into its evening mode. She downs the brandy in one gulp, then looks around, seeing an array of sumptuously atmospheric pools of light that have just welled up the length and width of her land, all for her sake alone, it seems. Many kinds of vegetation are lit from underneath or within, in yellow, orange, or red, while the ground is illuminated in numerous soft-edged circles of white from low-rise cylindrical or conical light fittings planted in the earth, of different heights and diameters, but all with downward-slanting louvred sides, like insulator cones from a power station roof or exotic metal pine cones. She returns to the kitchen, where she takes out a new glass and bottle from the cabinet. When she re-emerges, pausing at the open terrace doors, she is holding a different drink from before, a drink more in tune with those nighttime grid lights spread out ahead, and with the cigarette smouldering in her other hand, a tumbler of bourbon on the rocks, as befits an LA cityscape, above which the opening of the end should be heard striking up across the sky over those silhouetted palms on the ridges of the canyons. Bourbon on the rocks. Making her the first beast who has intuited the drink that her creator was drinking when he set about creating her. She draws on the cigarette, tilts her head back and puffs smoke out into the lamplight. She leans on the balustrade and savours a long swig of drink. A faint trace of heat from the land beneath the terrace is still perceptible, rising up behind the growing cool of the evening air. She raises the tumbler to eye level, feeling the condensation on the glass against her forehead, and peers inside it, through bourbon and ice. The lights of Los Angeles are distorted into squeaky lines and smudgy points, and the bones of the moon's disk flip and swing high to the west, where a crawling sea stretches to a whisky horizon.